Hi, students, let's start the second part of biological classification. Here we are going to take the revision of class 11 and 12, so hit the like and sub button for joining our revision journey. Pribby's video is of the introduction of the chapter, so click on the I button to see it. Let's start today. Kingdom Monera. Bacteria is the sole member of Monera. Sole means only one or single. They are in very large quantity microorganisms. The bacteria also live in various harsh conditions like hot springs, snow, deep oceans, deserts, etc. Many of them lives like parasite. Parasite means a plant or an animal that lives in or on another plant or animal and gets its food from it. Parasites sometimes cause disease. Bacteria are classified based on the shape. 1. Spherical coccus. 2. Rod-shaped bacillus. 3. Common-shaped vibrium. 4. Spiral spirillum. They show the most extensive metabolic diversity. Some bacteria are autotrophic in nature, which means they make their food. But most of the bacteria have heterotrophic in nature, which means they depend on others for food. Now start the Archaebacteria. The bacteria are known for living in very harsh habitats, like halophils, lives in very salty areas, thermoacidophiles, lives in hot springs. Cell of Archaebacteria is different from other bacteria, and this feature is responsible for living in very harsh conditions. Methanogens is present in ruminant of some animals. This leads to producing methane from the dung of some animals. Eubacteria. Eubacteria is known as true bacteria. They are characterized by the presence of rigid cell walls, and if are motile, and have a flagellum. Mycoplasma is the smallest bacteria present without a cell wall, and it's pathogenic for some animals and plants. Cyanobacteria is unicellular, colonial or filamentous, fresh or marine water, or terrestrial algae. Cyanobacteria has chlorophyll as similar to green plants and photosynthetic autotrophs. Cyanobacteria is also known as blue-green algae. Some of them fix atmospheric nitrogen in some specialized cells called heterocysts, for example. Nostoc, Anabina. Chemosynthetic bacteria oxidize various inorganic substance, i.e. nitrate, ammonia and nitrites, and they released energy for their energy production. Heterotrophic bacteria are most abundant in nature. They also known as decomposers, many of them is useful for human like making curd form milk, production of antibodies, fixing nitrogen in legume root, etc. And some are pathogenic for human means they are harmful for humans, for example, cholera, tetanus, citrus canker. Bacteria reproduce mainly by fission, but sometimes under unfavorable conditions they produce spores. They also reproduce by adopting a primitive type of DNA form one bacterium to the other. Let's start the kingdom Protista in next video. Please like and sub for more videos. Bye and stay tuned.